Good afternoon, everyone present over here. Beloved Bala sir, our guest, dignitaries on and off the dais, faculties, and my dear batchmates, it gives me immense pleasure to introduce Mr. Ranjan Sarkar, Vice President, Human Resource at CH Limited. Sir holds Master's degree of Business Administration from Symbiosis Institute of Business Management. Prior to MBA, sir was sales trainee under Department of Tourism for 2 years with West Bengal State Government. Sir has work experience of 15 years as Management Trainee Corporate HR in UB Group for 1 year, as Manager Corporate HR in GlaxoSmithKline for 4 years, in Z Group as Assistant Vice President HR Z Media Division for 3 years, as Assistant Vice President Business HR in Kotak Mahindra for 7 months, and now in CH Tyres as Vice President Human Resource. Sir has key professional achievements. He has led implementation of corporate HR processes for CH Sri Lanka and HR setup strategy for CH Bangladesh. Change assignment at CH through operational efficiency, talent landscaping, and leadership development. Greenfield HR project, scaling up a startup Dish TV to 1,000 crores, 1,200 manpower national operation. HR task force member to a successful mega merger, GlaxoSmithKline, Big Man. Now I would like to request sir to share his worthy wisdom to the gathering. Thank you.
Yeah, that is better. Good afternoon. I don't know whether when I was listening to other speakers, the voice was not very clear, so I chose this one. Can you hear me there, up there?
Yes, sir.
Clearly. Good. So, first of all, I'd like to thank you for the opportunity given to me to come here with all my humility, because I owe it to institutes for what I'm here today. So, with all my humility, I feel privileged to stand here and talk to you and to so many wonderful teachers out here. It's not going to be very boring, so just smile, okay? Just don't be so rigid in your chairs, just loosen up. So, how many of you think that in the last 2 years that you have been with BRM, and I'm told that first year, it was a regimented life for you of 16 hours. Second year, you get to stay out in the Pune city and you have fun. So, but as an individual, from the day you left home and start staying in Pune, got a vision last year, till 1.5 years now, how many of you think have gone through some fundamental changes in as a person? You've grown by age 1 year, but otherwise, what do you think has been the change so far? Patience. I don't really have too many slides. I just have half an hour to talk to you, so we'll just talk. So, good. Very important to pick up a local language. That gives you versatility. What else? Jargon mat bolo, time management bolo, kya sikha bolo, what is the thing that you have changed as a person? You have become more serious or more chilled out? You have learned to become more independent? When will this come up?
I request you all to stand and say.
No problem.
But lekar ke phadapat batayega.
I'm just, because the slides are not there, so I'm just trying to See, I don't have any functional presentation to talk to you all, because that's not my strength. I think there are distinguished faculties here who will talk to you about a lot of academics much better than me. Okay? So I thought I will share with you what I have experienced, the journey from how you have, from an engineering college student, when you come to an MBA college, what has been the change, and when you go to corporate, how the change happens to us as a person, and how the preparedness of that, some insights into that, which will help you be more prepared when you go to work in this corporate world, or whichever world for the matter. But my reference is more of a carpet wall. Okay. Is it that the file is not opening, or is it that it is not connecting? If you put it off, it's fine. I don't need to see. Oh, chhod dijiye. Ye idhar na laga dijiye. They need to see. I will refer here. Okay. Now my presentation has got one eligibility without which you cannot be able to follow it. You have to understand a game called cricket. So how many of you understand what is cricket? Those of you who have not put up your hands there, there is at least a bat. You know that there is a ball, the wickets. At least you know that that would be fine. Otherwise, everybody knows. So because what I tried to do is I've just used few slides and I've used cricket as a metaphor, because for me it's a game that is very similar to corporate world, because that involves temperament. And I wanted to just show how the movement happens in that world of cricketing. From a journey, from a state player to when you play World Cup, just like when you work, when you are engineering student or BSc, become students in your state, to come to a postgraduate level and how you work in the corporate world. So that's the metaphoric example I'm going to use. Okay? Still not there? What is happening? He's not getting. Yeah, give that only or something. I don't need it there. But it's still I am. What happened? Will come now? At least one? Still, we can't waste time. So basically, okay, let's talk. Okay. So what happened? I think the first two slides is something that you have already experienced, right? So you have all come from different states of this country. So of course, yes. So you have when you are an engineer or when you are a graduation student, what are some of those attributes or some of those environmental things that you had, which you see a change here? For example, I'll give you some leads. For example, in graduation days, you are maybe perhaps the most popular boy or girl of your school, of your college, right? It is a more known environment, a similar heterogeneous crowd, correct? What else? Father, mother was close by, maybe living in the home. Decisions, who is to take decisions mostly? No, don't just say for the sake of saying it. Tell me what is you truly believe. There were friends, lot of friends who actually friends more. What is your current state? What do you think? You're now in the second year. What are you experiencing now? Freedom. Okay. What about friendship? Does it exist anymore, or does it? I don't think that the friendship exists in the same pure way as it exists in your school or engineering day. I guess you'll be still having better friends in your graduation days, which you must be still in the Facebook in touch or what, kind of. So it doesn't happen, because here you are competitive. Okay, just it's very similar in cricketing world. When you go from okay, so you may have to look there. So okay, So you will just watch and then turn back and we will talk. And then again watch and turn back. Okay? So that is what I was talking to you. Now imagine, now you have come back to the MBA college. So you can see there what I have written. If you can't read, I'll just read out for you. You can just focus the camera closer. That is a better way. This is innovative. Now just adjust the cameraman, adjust the focus. Focus. Still not clear. Okay. So in college here, you will find it more competitive. You will find, most importantly, although there will be certain discipline. Hello, just focus here, what I'm saying. Do you see one change? At least I have experienced that. Suddenly you have to take decisions on your own and your parents don't tell you, your teachers don't tell you. You have a very disciplined campus that I'm aware of. But otherwise, you have started owning up your own, you are getting accountable for yourself, slowly. You are accountable for your decisions. Are you experiencing that? You will experience that tenfold going forward. Let me tell you this. That's the first fundamental change a cricketer goes through when he goes from a Ranji team to a national squad. He will also go through and when you go to actually towards the end of your, after your campus season and when you go to corporates. You will see that. Okay. I will not spend too much time here. But so what it reads is, what does the international coach, which is like your all gurus here, expect from you? So what happens when a state cricketer goes to a national squad for getting trained for wearing the blue dress, to represent India? What happens? You are going to represent Balaji Society. So what are you going to train as? So what will be the demand from your gurus here? Let's keep it to cricket. What happens to the cricketing? So all these good state Ranji players or all, what is that league, IPL players, when they get selected into national squad, what does the coach expect there? What do you think? I think the first is they teach you to get disciplined there, because they bring that rigor into you. I am sure you must be experiencing that here. Right, it is no more a free game or it's a lot of fun, lot of parties, but at the same time there is a lot of rhythm and discipline that you bring into your life, which was not there in us habitually when we are graduates, guys, when we are much more, you know, free birds in our respective cities. Okay, that's what comes in. What else comes in? Another thing that I think it comes in at a national level and hence at a post-graduation level is that you have to ask for what you want. Nobody will give you a free lunch. Do you guys ask? You have to ask to be part of the council. You have to project yourself to be part of the placement cell to get those privileges. Nobody will give you free. That will become stronger and stronger when you go to corporate. Do you ask? At least you make a promise today to me that after this day you will all ask for what you want. You have to stand up for everyone, because nothing will come easy to you. Yeah, so in a national squad, people have to ask for their rights. They have to ask for, nobody will just give you things. They will not give you technique just by that. They have to actually go to senior players. They have to tell them, please tell me techniques. I want to learn. So everything is your self-accountability. That's the big shift from a state level to a national level. Otherwise, on skill level, they're all the same. Knowledge level, I'm assuming if you have passed your graduation, you're all great. You all have good IQ and there is all average, above average IQ guys. But what comes next is the temperament to make these shifts. Are you getting there? What I'm saying? Okay, good. So that's the first shift. Okay. So, it's coming there. Very good. This is my reading of a difference between what happens in a college graduation to post-graduation. I've still not come to corporate as yet, okay? So, the syllabus changes, the environment changes from a non-competitive to competitive. The exposure And slowly, if you have seen, you have learning from independent contributor to become interdependent. I don't know how many of you are working on team assignments. Okay, in college days we used to always do what? Largely. Here I think you are more into team assignments. You are learning interdependence. As an adult, we have to learn interdependence. That's very important. Nothing you can do alone. Right? So that's the change according to me from these two syllabuses. Now, assume all of you have got good placements in campus. Okay, you have gone to play your first international match. What is international match for you? The first company. What happens to a cricketer when he goes to the first international match? Is he a runaway success? Very rare we hear. What happens? First match? Huh? Result kya hota hai yaar? Largely we will see they will dock or they will, great guys, they are great skill, except for one Sachin or one or two who also struggle, but initially they will fail, they will have their wickets bowled out, and these things will happen when you go to campuses. Okay, so what are the kind of feelings that will come is what I try to list down here. If you see, as you all said, I'm glad you are learning patience, because when you go to corporate world, I have experience with a lot of youngsters, there is an impatience to prove yourself immediately. Aaj join kiya, kal I have to prove myself. It doesn't happen. Even a cricketer cannot do that. Can they do that, do you think? Just remember this example, when you get disheartened wherever you join. First day you cannot prove yourself, isn't it? Saurav Ganguly was the Indian cricket captain. First 6 months he failed. He came into the team, came out of the team, came into the team for almost 6 months to a year. Things like that. We have examples. It's okay to fail, because that's how we learn. So that frustration or that impatience to prove yourself is very normal. But I am only making you aware, because I don't have answer to all this. Okay, so don't look at me like that. I am also gone through all these things, and I am only sharing so that there is a faster learning for you, which I have learnt a little more with a little more time. At least a next generation will learn faster. So this is what will happen. This is what I have observed. You will feel the second point is very important. Even in cricketing world, the youngsters feel that they will question the captain too much. They will feel nobody understands their point of view. You'll feel like that when you go to cop initially, because you have learned a lot of things and you want to prove, and you want to say without knowing perspectives, you want to prove many times. So you'll feel that at cricket, okay, at the national level, at national squad, so youngster might say, why should I come at this point? Why is the captain taking that decision? I'm not being asked. I'm a talented player. You know, there's a feeling that my point of view is not being heard. Getting? Many times for failures you will blame whom? Luck. Okay, I am so talented. Suppose you are a good cricketer, got chance in the cricket team, failed. Maybe you wanted to open, you were given the slogging overs. You know what's a slogging overs towards the end? And you feel ke mere ko 5 over hi mila, mujhe proof karne ka chance hi nahi mila, I am out. So you blame failure, this captain is faltu. So those things are very natural when you go into national core, you're playing international matches, and in your context, when you go to corporate world, you will face all this. Okay? Which is okay. So what would be something that you need to develop according to me as a management graduate, because management is not an academic subject. Okay. There are a lot of things that you learn in inputs, but what is the only thing do you think this management education, through some of this management education and the initial in your area, initial years of your corporate life, one has to build. Can anybody tell me what is that one thing that needs to develop? It's not knowledge. Knowledge will come, and today knowledge can be bought. Knowledge is very easy to download. What is that one thing that one has to develop in these 2 years of MBA and next 2-3 years in your first initial? Think of cricket, you'll get the answer. Absolutely. Bang on. Temperament is the important thing that one has to develop over the first, because the temperament to hold the nerve, temperament to kind of to handle setbacks. These are things I have experienced when I was younger than you, when I just joined. These are the things that actually, yeah, you want to say something? You want to ask something? No, next. I just saw you raise your hand. You can feel free to just stop me anytime because I don't know where to stop. So just feel free to ask questions. Yeah. So what do you think that temperament gives you and gives you success? What has happened to some of these players I'm just sharing? How does the temperamenting helps? Okay. So it's how to be in that playing 11. That's what the metaphor says. The dependency on you have to build up by being consistent. Getting? That side is very quiet. You don't know cricket? You know? So dependency, you understand? Okay? That consistency. We say another cricket has to be consistent. Means what? That is a dependency on him. He has a temperament to hold on. Because everybody likes dependent people who are strong, who are resilient, who can. And everybody knows in this world is full of problems. Nobody has the magic wand. Nobody is expecting you to solve in 2 days. But your ability to stand, hold the ground, face the problem, this is what temperament gives you. Okay? Good. What else? Let's see. What does this mean in cricketing language? What does this mean? The heading. If you know one dayers and all that, international matches, do you think only the big sixers make you win the match? And you can just laze around for all time and you can just hit 2-3 sixes and that will win you match? No. What makes you win? Running? Huh? Yeah, those small opportunities which you make do of. You convert your ones to twos and twos to threes. Isn't it? That's what that in a corporate life, to make use of the small, you will never get the best of the project or the best of the job out of campus. Just for knowledge, I am the last guy who got placed in campus. Okay? And there's a company called GlaxoSmithKline, which I was very keen on at campus. For some reason I could not get. After almost quite a while, after campus I got that company. So it's not that if I don't get something in campus, I don't get it later. But I waited for that company, I found out about the opportunities there. Okay? So making those twos to threes are very important in the corporate life, and that's the thing that will give you success. They're steady, making use of opportunities and not wasting. It's not the big sixes, always. Okay? Big sixes are all your lucks and opportunities, breaks that you get. So what else? What else do you think? Let's look at some more examples. What does this mean? Somebody has to explain to me this. What does this mean? Okay, is it okay? Suppose you are playing with him in your, I just visited your hostel. You are playing there, cricket. And there was a difficult catch and he misses. What will you tell him? आपको बता रहा हूँ मैन अरे वो तो मालूम है बट आई एम सेइंग यू आर प्लेइंग क्रिकेट देयर वाज अ वेरी डिफिकल्ट कैच आउट देयर हे यू आर फॉलोइंग मी द बॉल इज आउट देयर वेरी डिफिकल्ट ही हैज टू डाइव एंड कैच द बॉल ही मिस्ड इट व्हाट विल यू टेल हिम व्हाटएवर इफ Suresh Raina misses it in international match, in a World Cup match against Pakistan. What will you tell him? Huh? Gali dega tum usko. Dega ki nahi? Gali dega kon kon aur you will abuse him or you will say kya theek hai yaar ek miss hai. Huh? Why? Yes. Yeah, your tolerance to mistakes at that level is very low. Correct? Your tolerance to mistakes at an international level is very low compared to a gully cricket. So as you progress into your corporate life, as you grow senior, tolerance to your mistakes will also be low. Natural? So that's how I'm just trying to bring up some aspects of corporate life. So as you grow senior, the expectations, like lady said there beautifully, that the expectation changes and that stake will grow higher and higher, and one has to be aware of that. Not that I'm not trying to scare you or anything, but I'm just trying to help you with how the corporate world runs and how you will experience as you grow up the ladder. Okay? Okay. What does the Dusra plan mean? Yeah. So we have all learned to make a plan in life. That you have a plan A, you have a plan B. As a mature professional, as you grow, you have to. And these are very, you know, are you finding these useful, or I'm just taking feedback, or I'm just talking? You're not finding it useful. Do you make sense? I'll go ahead with some more slides. Audience engagement is very important. Do I go ahead with some more slides?
Yes, sir.
Okay. So, Dusra plan means the plan B. As a professional, as you go, you will have a plan that we have all learned and we have taught. For successful professionals or better professionals, you have to have a plan B. Okay, that's what a Dusra means, right? So, that's another thing. What does these three gentlemen stand for? Yeah. So, even in sport, as in corporate life, nothing will substitute your personal excellence. Personal excellence ka matlab? What is personal excellence? You are a very intelligent lady, you please tell. Yeah. What's personal excellence? Excellence, personal excellence, that what value addition I have to give, that's personal excellence, right? Your personal, because if you are hollow and you want to just run a big world, it will never happen. So you have to, there is no shortcut to personal excellence, the personal capability that you develop in yourself, right? And for personal excellence, you don't have to chase success. The success, we all know those examples, I don't want to talk cliche things, but personal excellence is very important. There is no substitute for this. Right? And this is my personal belief. It may not be yours, because this is at a very, and this is something I cannot advocate to any of you. This is my personal belief that above all, if you know this gentleman, you know what he stands for to me? What? What do he stands for to you? He never played for himself, right? So according, and this is, as I said, this is the last slide, so I'll not bore you anymore. For me, this is my personal belief, it may not be yours, I'm just telling you upfront, that above all, as a good leader, that humility and to be honest to yourself can never be compromised. Whether you make success or you fail, as an individual, we have to be a good human being first, before anything else, right? So, even in cricket, as in world, unless like a person like him, if you are not honest to the purpose for which you are doing, I don't think somewhere in life it bites you. It's my personal belief. So these are some of the cricketing lessons that I have seen applied to me when I grew from a management trainee to in the last 15 years to here, to whatever assignments I have done in the last 15 years. I feel some of these are very generic and it will apply to your generation too, because this is not very it doesn't change so much. And if you can learn these skills, what I've talked to, and there could be many, but at least if you learn this temperament building on these aspects, and definitely cricket teaches us that, I think that will help you be more prepared than I am perhaps. Perhaps you will be doing much better than me because at least you are aware of certain things which I took a lot more time to understand. It took me a lot of time to understand these things, not initially. At least you are aware now. So, accountability and temperament, right? Promise? that has to come. So, I'm a little running short of time, so I am through. If you want to ask me any question, free. I just thought I will, Dr. Abdi is not here. No. So, Professor, I just thought that I will not talk about any subject. I will talk about this.
Very good, sir. Very good.
Because I didn't want to load with any functional presentation.
All our pointers.
I mean, I didn't want to talk about HR and all that. So, I just wanted to share about what I have. Yeah. So, if anything that you want to talk to me as a big brother, I can, I mean, I'm just a little more senior to you, that's all. But you want to ask me something, I can share.
Hello. Hello.
Yeah. Yes, somebody said hello, I don't know. Huh? You said hello.
Yes.
Anyway, your campus. Good, your campuses are coming up soon. Okay, do well, be competitive, but please respect others also. Because as I said, we just discussed that we'll be competitive with humility. So do well, but and also be respectful for others, which who will also do well, because that's what we do as an adult. We have to do well and we have to also respect others. And don't fight among yourself in campus, I mean, she'll say. Okay, all the best. Thank you.
Sir, I would like to ask some questions.
Yes, sir.
See, what are the common problems or drawbacks which you notice in the fresh graduate you recruit? The campus se jaate hain.
Sir, if you refer to this summary slide of mine, I think I will not use the word drawback, because I think everybody is a bunch of intelligent people here. The very fact they have come to this level and got opportunity to crack, to get into biology and several other campuses that they go to, there is a basic level of IQ and intelligence everybody has. But what I feel is there are couple of things which may not be so much of a problem in this, but one is that there is a impatience to quickly prove something. So while that is what I was trying to share, that if you give it time, build your temperament, work at an operational area, and many times I've observed for marketing people, it is brand. For HR, it is corporate learning and development. For finance, it is treasury. And for supply chain, it is planning. These are areas where they want to quickly go into. Everybody wants that. I want brand, I want corporate HR, I want LNOD, I want supply chain students are here. So LNOD, and then then it is planning in supply chain, and finance guys only want treasury and FP&A, that is financial planning. Now problem is that if they, I will just like to share here that there are two people whom I know who have, thankfully, 2 years they have worked in sales and they quickly got into product management. After 4 years, when did you click that? Okay. Okay, after 4 years, they have grown in product management and they never wanted to go into business. And today they are stuck in their careers because they are unable to become business heads because they have not handled P&L, profit and the sales and the profit and loss. So it's not a drawback, but I would urge, we urge and we actually course youngsters that you please work in the area which is more connected to the ground, which is for HR students, it will be working with the business HR or with the, say, plant HR, plant IR, working with the people than sitting in corporate LNOD or corporate CNB. For sales and marketing students, sales and marketing, you can become the best CEO in this country when you know the customers very well, and that only comes from when you work in the field. So people have a tendency, sir, to come to ask for corporate roles very fast. Under pressure also to retain, we sometimes give, but it doesn't help them. and people have done much better who have handled more customer facing, more ground roles. So that's what I feel.
The next question, sir, what is that key one knowledge, I mean one aspect you feel resulted to knowledge area where they should be perfect? One thing you should say, okay, you should be perfect in this, for all discipline put together. At least they can start updating.
You asked me about knowledge, you didn't ask me about behavior. If I would have asked me about behavior, I would have said temperament. But if you're asking me about knowledge, sir, I think the only knowledge that one can be very, really, really, you know, that should they should be really imbibing is about the habit of acquiring knowledge continuously, because knowledge is changing so much. I think that there is nothing I can say that today this is good or tomorrow it's bad. So if one has the temperament of continuously acquiring knowledge and what is happening, I think that's the biggest knowledge one can have. Yeah, you found a question after 15 minutes. Good. Sorry, Nate, don't say sorry.
Sir, my name is Rohit Dutta. I'm from BMHRD.
Yes.
If you are in a recruitment process and if you are recruiting a PGDM student who is a fresher, what would be your core expectancy out of that student?
See, different people look for different things. I can only answer this question for myself. Okay? I would, if I am a recruiter, I think there is a very famous thing that we learn over a period of time in corporate world, that you recruit a person on attitude and train him on skill. Okay? You recruit on attitude and you train on skill. I can build your skill level or knowledge level, but I can never change your attitude, because that's very core to you. When you grew up from a child from 10 years to 18 years, that's the personality development that happened to you. That I cannot change, because there is several factors, your parents, teachers, relatives who has built up to that attitudinal, that personality of yours. So if you ask me what I look at, I look at attitudinal things. Are you flexible? Are you positive? Are you honest? Are you courageous? Can you call spade a spade? These are the things I will look at, and rest I think you learn on the job. What's the big deal? So even in campuses, when you sit for different companies, I mean, I just be yourself and be honest and be upfront. I think people like these qualities these days. There's nothing to really kind of train yourself or about, and basic knowledge they'll expect all of you have. Did I answer that?
And last question, sir.
Yes, sir.
It's a little, I should not ask the question, but then I have to ask this question. What is this? Is there a bias of male, female, job related bias?
Standing here, I will tell the truth, yes, to this audience, because I don't want to lie. I feel whatever we have done, there's still a bias in this world. Okay, I mean, we can talk about diversity and all that thing at a big level. Don't quote me to any journalist. I mean, please don't record this statement. But for learning, I feel there is still a bias in this world. And there is still a, you know, in my own company and in several companies, there are many places where they find it very difficult to push. I'm talking about gender bias right now, not other biases. There could be caste bias and all that. I'm not going into that. I'm talking about the gender bias. So there is a difficulty level, because I think it's actually a very big subject, sir. So maybe some other time we need to discuss, because fundamentally there is an expectation a male audience has from a female audience, and there is a reverse expectation that they have in the corporate world, which sometimes comes in conflict. And I still see that there is bias is there. It is thanks to a lot of policies and a lot of these social pressures that are changing it over a period of time. But it exists not just in India. Our group company, Zensar, which is a Pune company, acquired a company called Akibia in US. Even there also it's an IT company, but you know, where it's supposed to be, but still there is that skewed ratio. And I feel personally, sir, that this is not a corporate issue. This is more of a, it's much bigger, it's a social issue.
unless that bias changes at a society level, it can, because corporate is just a subset of the society. So it, if the bigger ecosystem, that bias is not there, then that corporate world doesn't change. For example, and Deep is sitting here, you can actually add to this point. We have got our sales organization, they're very averse to taking girls. Reason being, our sales managers, they go into interiors, they face dealers, you know, tire dealers. These tire dealers are businessmen, educated or non-educated. They're in small places where you don't have basic facilities, also difficult, I can, and biologically for a woman to operate, okay? They will abuse, they will make a lot of crack jokes and all that, because they're not a very, so unless the societal thing changes, and now because the environment is such, my regional manager does not want to take a lady sales executive because he is scared. Okay, it is, so the bias is coming from a bigger social ecosystem which is affecting this bias. Now assuming it was not like that and you go to any village of Uttar Pradesh and the person's outlook towards male and female is the same, then what is the problem in having a lady executive? But because those difficulties are, social difficulties are affecting, that is affecting the corporate world too. That is what is my observation, sir. But women, we find great female managers, they do better than men in many aspects. There are many strengths that men have, but there are many strengths that women also has.
Stand.
Yes.
In Ajmer zone I was working.
Yes.
I found out that SEAT has only one dealer, that also PCR, no HCV radial, no HCV radial. Besides that, instead of going pro dealer, you are going anti dealer by reducing your overdue adjustment from 60 to 30 days, PD adjustment from 30 to 7 days, and trade discount from 1% to 0.8%.
Are you, what figures the explanation? Abhi kaise karu? What is your question?
Why are you not trying to expand? Instead of expanding, we are contracting.
So there are, what do you want to talk about it? Tell. You can answer that question offline. Because it's not really related. It's a very local strategic issue. I cannot answer in one sentence. There are a lot of other matters that are affecting the market. I mean, but what is the intention for asking this question with respect to this subject? Okay, but that was a very, very specific question for Ajmer market, right? So that you can take offline, but any other, I didn't understand really the relevance, but any other broader question? Yeah? Okay. Yeah, I need to leave. Thanks, sir, because I missed the, thank you very much. Thank you, all the best, all of you.